Bwah, bwah, bwah. It's another TromBonus episode. It's just Rob, Celine, Engineer Joey, and a pocket full of dreams as we rehash the 6 million ways to live at point blank. Grab a rum and coke and boost up your speakers and tweeters because we're going through the ska of dub pistols on Checkered Past, the Ska'd cast. What up, checkerheads? Welcome to Checkered Past, the Ska'd cast with Celine and Rob, the show where Matt Hoffman's pro BRX bandits and Kelly Slater's pro Sir Fury of the Aquabats explore the history and impact of a different band each episode, hope to bring in new fans along the way. I'm Rob, and this is my sister and co-host, Celine.
What was that? What was it?
A mouthful.
What was that? Kelly Slater. Who's Kelly Slater?
He's a pro surfer.
He's a pro surfer.
Oh, okay. Do people know about who pro surfers are other than like
people who made PlayStation video games?
Yeah, these were
Kelly Slater was from. Okay.
These were Tony Hawk spin-offs.
Yeah. That were like surf.
They had a surf one.
That one was.
They had a wave boarding one, I think. They had a snowboarding one.
Wave boarding.
And they had Matt Hoffman's BMX.
BMX. Yeah. Oh, BMX makes this cooler.
And then they had,
did we introduce who this mystery person talking is?
Oh, yeah. Hi, Joey.
Oh, hi, Joey's here. Yeah. Do you guys remember there was also like a BMX game that was like XXX BMX or something stupid, and they got banned for having boobs in it?
I was thinking of that fucking game the other day.
Oh, I thought Vin Diesel was in it.
He's kind of a boob.
Is he?
Yeah, no.
Plays harsh. We're not gonna have him on the pod. Yeah. He likes D&D.
Do you remember that one time?
He might like ska.
His head looks kind of like a boob. How about that?
All right.
Fun.
I'll take it.
Fun.
Point is, I do remember XXX BMX.
Yeah,
I do remember.
And it had like so many. Like I remember renting it and being like, well, at the very least, maybe the soundtrack will be like as good as one of these other games. And it was not.
It's not good.
It's not good.
That's one thing you can count on is you're supposed to be able to count on playing like a extreme sports video game.
And even if it sucks, good music.
It would have good music.
Extremely good.
And it's very relevant to today's episode because the reason why I had those is because one of the mainstays of video game soundtracks in the early aughts was a band called Dub Pistols.
I've never heard of them.
So this was recommended by.
That means nothing to me.
Yeah,
you got me running in a cyclone.
You got me running in a cyclone.
Yeah,
that's a mouthful for cyclone.
Yeah,
a cyclone.
Yeah, they
got
did
me
it.
Running in a cyclone.
That's fun. I like that. Well, I like that.
Yeah, it's fun. So they this was suggested by Common Sense Kid on the Discord.
Oh, it's Brit Craigie. Stuff.
Oh, yeah.
It is definitely Brit stuff.
It's Brit stuff. This is our first foray into electronic music, y'all.
Oh. Whoa. More Brit stuff.
More Brit stuff. Heavy. Are we? So how do we feel about the genre of big beat?
Give me more examples of what big beat is.
Fatboy Slim.
Well, that's fine.
The Chemical Brothers.
Yeah, I like it.
But not all of it.
Yeah.
Not all of it.
Like
cherry, I have to be like a cherry picking daddy about it.
Yeah. If you're a fire starter, that's
Prodigy
a song.
Is the big beat.
Yeah, they're a little bit on the industrial side, but they got big beat elements. Basically, if
big
it's like
beat energy.
If it's like drum and bass or like break beat music with like kind of a arena rock feel to it, that's basically big beat.
But not what Imagine about, Dragons.
Yeah, and what about the Cramps? They had big beats in Badsville, didn't they?
Yeah.
No, I see.
Yeah.
No, but yes. But I see what you did.
Excellent.
It's not a good example, but it's a good joke.
Yeah. All right.
That's what it
is. There's definitely Fatboy Slim would be my numero uno.
Fatboy Slim rules.
Yeah, Chemical Brothers as well. I listen to quite a bit of Chemical Brothers.
You can go with it. Or that... Praise You Sweet. Praise You Fucking
What about the Rockefeller Skank? It's got ska in it.
Yeah. Which one's that one? How does it go? I never like attribute the name to like how that song sounds.
Right, because that's not the
How does
the
it hook. Sound? Someone say hum it.
I'm kind of lost on it.
No, I'm also forgetting. So now I'm going to look up. I know it's something stupid. Oh, yeah. Look like right a about now. The Funk Soul Brother.
Yeah. Where's the ska?
Rockefeller Skank.
That's the only ska.
Yeah.
Oh, I thought I was like, what in the song? No. Did I like miss something? Right about now, the Funk Soul Brother. Check it out now.
The Funk. Yeah, that's a big beat song.
That's fun.
Yeah. Crystal Method. Oh, I see that here. Crystal Method,
yep.
Basement Jax. Where's your head at?
Yeah. But like, what other Basement Jax song do you know? Are they all Brits?
No, most of those are American. Basement Jax, I believe, is...
They seem British. I don't know if
they're
that's
British.
True. Okay. They just specifically them.
Yeah, I feel like Big Beat sound was kind of like...
Isn't Fatboy Slim British? Invasion,
but oh, yeah, electronic. He is. Yeah.
Fatboy Slim.
Okay, maybe they're all British.
Yeah, they're all British.
I'm just saying.
Oh, Crystal Method is not. American.
They're American. Yeah. Everyone else is British. Chemical Brothers, for sure.
Yes, they are for sure.
Yeah, Brits.
Yeah, Brits.
Do you listen to EDM music at all? That's my question.
Yeah, I like more like dark gothy electro or just like dumb. But I also like some like top 40 electro, you know.
I like good electro stuff.
Yeah,
it has to be pretty dancey though for me.
There are too many subgenres in the electronic music library of subgenres for me to even really know what I like. But yeah, I don't have any issue with synthesizers and drum machines and any kind of music that has that sort of stuff. If it's good, it's good.
I'm really into this band called Nightclub, and they're just like this like goth, kind of like lazy goth industrial band. They've did like a lot of just instrumental stuff for like movies before, but they're a really good like goth electronic band. It's like dancey and fun. I highly recommend.
I read something where apparently this is a thing. If you're like really into EDM music, you hate it when people call it EDM.
Yeah. Oh. Yeah, I've heard of that as well.
Because it's like saying you're a fan of rock music.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
right.
It's like so broad of a term.
What I don't
or even
like
punk music. If someone's like, I love punk music. It's like, what the fuck does that even mean?
Yeah. I wouldn't say this has as much like the big beat is a little more closer to rock than it is like the greater.
Yes.
Like you wouldn't go to Shambhala and see Fatboy Slim. You know what I'm saying? Shambhala,
or
I guess for
Daisy
people who
Festival.
Don't know, is the Burning Man of Canada.
Yeah.
Would Burning Man might have a Fatboy Slim though?
They might.
They got like a Diplo and stuff.
I feel like Big Beat.
I like Diplo.
I feel like Big Beat is more, and correct me if I'm wrong here, but I feel like it uses more samples, generally speaking, than actually like reorchestrating new music with synthesizers. They use a lot of samples and reuse.
And it's not like Pendulum or like LCD Sound System, where like they're a live band that is also an electronic band.
No,
right?
No, it's very much like a production team.
What's
the groups
gorillas?
Are production team. It's a studio production band with
the
a bunch
gorillas.
Of super bands.
Yeah, the Gorillaz is Gorillaz.
The Gorillaz is Matt Albarn. Is that
I
his name?
I didn't ask who
Damon
they are.
Damon Albarn.
What are they as a genre?
Dan the Automator.
Oh, that's what you're asking.
Well,
yeah.
Is this January?
The guy who made Tank Girl.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you think Craig likes the Gorillaz?
Yeah, yes. He yeah.
It's
the single thing is like the Gorillaz thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And also, maybe he's got a cup. Who knows? Maybe. We'll see.
I like...
And ska also, because what was it? Ghost Town? Sampled in Clint Eastwood?
Correct.
Mm-hmm.
It's all coming back to ska.
I learned that from the pod.
And so today we're talking about... Oh, I like French Touch. French Touch is sweet.
What do they do?
It's a type of EDM music.
Well, so is that when someone bonks you with a baguette?
Yep. I got ham bonked by a baguette. Yeah.
What example?
Daft Punk.
That's fun. Chromeo?
No, that's just like new disco, new fun.
I like
They're
that.
Great. I love Chromeo.
Yeah, Chromeo.
Justice.
Okay, I like
They're
Justice.
Great. Yeah. That's French
Mastercraft?
Touch.
What's Mastercraft?
That's like dance punk.
I love dance punk, that's fun.
Yeah, like
Mastercraft is sick.
DFIA 1979. That's all dance punk.
Death from Above is dance punk. I love dance. They don't make dance punk like that anymore. There was a time and it was good and I liked it.
I was saying when I went to
come
see Chick
you,
Chick
baby,
Chick.
Baby, I love your company.
Yeah, they fucking ruled. Like that kind of electronic music is right up my alley.
So yeah, that's so the good. Stuff I like.
Yeah, it's great. I also got into recently something called Future Funk, which I'm like late to the game on, is a subgenre of vaporwave, my least favorite kind of electronic music, but it's sick. It's actually really good. It's very funky.
Okay.
I like
it. How is it a subgenre of vaporwave?
It doesn't make any sense. I don't understand, but all these vaporwave musicians went from making like boring refrigerator music to making funky music, and it's sick. And I like Sweet. Funk.
So. I tried to go to a couple kind of like ravey things, and it was like not great. I had like chemical drugs for like 3 months, and I was like, oh, I don't like that either. And so I was like, I guess this is it. Yeah. And I was like, I can't stay up.
Yeah.
And
there's like
people are weird and gross. There's a whole deal. Yeah. And no judgment if that's your thing. It just absolutely was not for me.
Also, the scene may be different here than other places in the world too, because our electronic music scene generally in Edmonton is a really ravey sort of sound, generally speaking. So it is kind of
like happy hardcore. Yeah. And I'm like, shoot me now. Do you like happy hardcore?
No, I dislike it. Oh, it's too much.
Maybe actually the worst music, like in my mind.
200 beats per minute, but it's like all
pitched up. It's worse than Real Big Fish.
It'd be really funny if people just started like referring to like Turnstile as happy hardcore.
Because it's hardcore, but it's upbeat.
Yeah. It's happy hardcore.
I'll give you that. Magnolia Park.
Or like a dubstep's kind of dumb too.
Dubstep just got broed.
I like dubstep because dubstep is just metalcore with synthesizers instead of guitars.
That's why all the metalcore dudes ended up becoming like your Skrillexes of the world.
I still don't like the wub wub wub, you know.
I don't need
hurting,
a bass drop.
You're hurting Craig's feelings.
Does he love wub wub wub?
Yeah, he loves wub wub wub. Black Hole has only wub 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 as far as bass is concerned.
Well,
I
didn't that way, but you know what I mean. The breakdown.
This is the most we've talked about Craig on an episode he didn't appear
on. That's a Craig fan episode.
Yeah. So why don't
he did make the playlist?
That's true.
Yeah.
So thank you. So why don't we talk about the Dub Pistols? Okay, so they are. Guess what? They're from England. They're a big beat band from England.
Gasps in British.
But
oh my.
They like to do, oh my, they love breaks, and they love ska, and they love reggae, and they love dub, and they love all that fun stuff. So,
I like that stuff.
So it's all kind of mixed into like a little crock pot of fun. And
I prefer subtitles.
Huh?
Over
instead
dubs.
Of dubs. No.
You know what? I'm a subs over dub too.
Yeah.
I feel you.
I am subs over dubs.
I'm subs over dubs. I can read. I'm fine. So why don't we tarry no further? We're going to 1998. We're gonna do a shallow dive. It's a TromBonus, so we got some songs picking and choosing off of the random albums. Okay, this is from the debut. This is the one that
shallow
Joey...
Lady Gaga.
Oh, I see. Oh.
Yeah, that's the.
I hate that song.
Yeah, that's the part where she just like screams.
Man, I thought she was just gonna like call. I felt like she called it quits.
And the
Lady Gaga is officially retired. She just wrote the biggest stinker of her career.
It's not bad.
But then she made a gajillion dollars.
Then she made more music.
Pause up, Little Monsters.
Cyclone from their debut album. Point Break, the one that Joey was talking about. Let's listen to it.
Oh, scratchies. Slynn loves it.
I love scratchies. I'm a scratchies for life.
What year is this?
98.
Yeah, that's not the time for scratching.
Yeah, oh yeah, it is.
100%
this type
is.
Of music it is.
Okay, this is fun. Oh, lasers. Yep. I like lasers.
Do you know who else loves lasers?
This band?
Dr. Luke.
Oh. he didn't produce this.
No.
Oh my God, I thought that's what you're...
Also, there's rapping. I should mention that they like rapping.
Oh, yeah.
I like this rapping.
This is Tony Hawk. This is just nostalgia bomb playing Tony Hawk for hours and hours and hours.
This is good.
Yeah,
it's so
right?
good.
It's good.
This is good. I will say.
I'm in the cyclone.
This is cyclone?
I'm in the cyclone.
That's fun. Yeah. This is good and fun. I like this.
It is good and it's fun.
Genuinely. This is kind of a fun nostalgia.
A little scratch break.
I don't mind the scratches.
Oh, yeah. Because it fits.
It's not like an Limp Bizkit wave.
Is
that what you're comparing it to?
Yeah.
You're not comparing it to like
Or
mix,
like,
mix
I don't know, the other
Mike
garbage we've
A-track.
Heard on this fucking podcast.
With
I don't
scratching?
Know, scratch
yeah, that's okay. The scratching
on
this podcast has never been good.
Yeah.
Do you, can you Celine,
Smash Mouth?
Did you ever see
that
Executioner's song? Did you ever see the music video for Executioner's?
Executioners are rad.
Yeah. You must have never seen it because scratching was bad in the end of the 90s for the most part, especially on rock music.
But history of scratching.
Yeah, but that's also while that garbage scratching was
happening. White boy scratching
this
is
song
different.
Came out. This song came out by a group called Executioners, and I'm pretty sure the person singing on it was Mike Shinoda.
Could be.
It was one of the Linkin Park guys, I'm pretty sure. But it was literally like Mixmaster Mike and two other DJs just cutting like an entire song, and it's bananas.
DJ
and the video is
Hubert
crazy.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure Hubert, who's from.
I feel like DJ culture, unfortunately, has just been destroyed by like DJ Pauly D and the like. honestly, those times at Paris Hilton, or Paris, yeah, DJ. That's what I pictured.
Who was Paris Hilton's like DJ friend who became like super famous? And all he would do is just show up to the club and play like
DJ
hits.
Press Play.
Yeah, there was that is a thing.
Do you know
and
what's
I
that
do,
guy's
but
name?
It's not. It's
I cannot remember
man.
His name, and he sucked so bad. Anyway, and he would just be like the DJ of celebrities.
My growing up with scratching wasn't good.
No, well, that's what I'm saying. There was like one time.
I liked what I heard just now. I liked what I heard just now.
There were a few good examples of it, and this is definitely
this is one of them.
Yeah. And so we're going to move forward in time to 2001. Whoa. And they start to hook up with a little man.
A little man. That's fun. All of them?
Whose name is Terry Hall of the Specials.
Oh. Okay.
And so he starts to collab pretty heavily.
Is he a little man?
He's a little man.
I don't think Terry Hall is like that.
I hope people are watching where I'm putting my fingers together, steepled my fingers together. Like I just revealed something.
He's very small.
And one of the tracks off of this is named, the one he appears on this album called 6 Million Ways to Live. It's called Problem Is a Little Man.
A little man. Did you know, you didn't catch my
people? Oh, spooky.
And you reveal all the people. Remember that thing? Yeah, I don't know how to do
it. Wait, no, I can do it.
Actually,
I can't show it on the mic.
The fuck are you guys doing?
Steeple people.
We're doing the steeple people.
This is fun.
This is rad.
Cool.
Yeah.
This is kind of spooky.
Yeah, that's what I said right at the beginning.
No, I was too busy steepling. I like how understated the vocals have been.
Yeah. This is very Madness-esque.
Also, I feel like they would conserve energy performing. You know, it's not like... they're not, like, going all out. They're just, like, kind of like... Yeah, no, he's still conserving energy. I feel like he wouldn't be exhausted after a show. Like, he's not jumping around.
I'm glad you're happy. He's a feature, too.
Yeah.
He would show up and do his bit, and then he would just walk off.
What's he doing after the show that he needs to conserve his energy for?
Life. Like, just getting
He's just
by.
A little
I'm
man.
I'm projecting.
It's a
I'm
long
so
walk
tired.
Home when that small.
Oh, I'm all about conserving energy these days. I'm like, what's he doing? I'm like, yeah, I guess you could
You look at
chill.
Plant life and you're like, what are you doing?
I'm like,
conserving
yeah.
energy.
Yeah.
That was great.
It's so good.
Yeah, that was
two
good.
For two.
Yeah, that was very Madness-esque. Like the bass line, was it like an old school Madness song for sure? It was cool.
How were you aware of them before this? Just
I knew I was running around like a cyclone. Yeah. That was most of my
opinion. I kinda want to run around like a cyclone. Yeah.
But you're probably wondering, what is this band most famous for? How would I know this band?
Is it not Cyclone?
Well, there was a hit ska track that they put out. Do you want to go and hit that number two there? You probably won't be familiar with this one.
This one?
Yeah.
What is this?
Remember this song?
Cake. What does this have to do with
cake? Oh, this is Dub Pistols. Do you remember this Dub Pistols song?
Why are you being funny?
Wait, no, there's a cool part that happens in this. You've never heard this, I think. Like,
what are you, yeah, what are you doing? What's your bit?
I also love the ska in this song.
What are you doing?
What are you doing?
Very low energy vocals, conserving a lot of energy.
He is!
Yeah.
What are you doing right now?
No,
what's the joke?
Stuff. Wait, there's trumpets. You'll like it.
No, I know, but what does this have to do with the
song?
They changed to Cake? Cake used to be a dub. The Cake used to be the other band?
I don't know who you're talking about. I'm talking about Dub Pistols.
Isn't this Cake?
Wait, they do a cool thing. Wait, there's a cool thing that happens.
It's a jacket?
Wait.
Oh.
Isn't that a cool thing?
That's what you were waiting. Okay, what's the deal?
It's a really cool song that
Seinfeld
came out in 2001.
What is the deal?
Remember that song? Joey, do you remember,
that song? Yeah.
That song.
And today's the day I murdered my own brother.
And so in 2007, the Dub Pistols released an album called Speakers and Tweeters, which I hate that title. Speakers and Tweeters. But guess who's still
Shouldn't
here?
It be Woofers and Tweeters?
That's kind of you. You're a speaker and a tweeter.
Very infrequently on both. There's so much more Terry Hall on this one, so much than ever before. So let's listen to the song Running from the Thoughts.
Been doing so much running.
I want to give it up for Britta.
Oh, Brit talk. Okay, wait, so why did we just listen to Kate?
I don't know what you're talking about. You're saying something weird that I don't understand. We just listened to a cool ska song by Dub Pistols from 2001.
I don't understand. Joey, do you know what's happening?
Mm-mm.
Okay.
No idea, I'm just rolling with it.
I keep waiting for the reveal.
This is a cool song, though.
Yeah, it's just hard to focus on cool anything song. Else. I'm not present in this. I hate him. He's just dancing smugly, having a nice time.
I'm having a nice time.
This is a good song.
This is a good song.
Yeah.
You've never clapped before in your life. Why are you clapping now? I've never.
That's a good song.
Clap.
Well, it's good.
So, is this ska to y'all?
That one was ska adjacent, I would say. Yeah.
Are you feeling the ska?
I mean,
this?
It's got.
No,
it's
I'm not feeling anything until I get answers.
Hey, you got upbeats. You got like guitars on the upbeats. You got horns going on. It's like British flip.
It's dub reggae inspired music.
Yeah.
With some electronicness.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's cool. I like it. Good. And then another song on there, they did a cover that you might recognize, also with Terry Hall. It's called Gangsters.
When I loaded this up, I kind of was hoping it would be this.
Is it a cover?
It's straight up Gangsters, yeah. And they showed Dub Pistols.
This is fun and scary. They like being scary.
It's a special song.
I know. That I know.
Okay, that you know.
That
yeah,
I know.
They kind of added a little like pep to the step in the song.
Yeah.
It's good. So British.
I like that Terry Hall in the 2000s is like actually singing.
Yeah.
Instead of whatever he was doing before.
That's almost like a catchier version.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And spookier.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's like
That's
a very
good.
It's like,
so good.
Like a solid update.
Yeah, but still honored, but it was different enough to make it worthwhile doing.
Yeah.
That was very good.
We're hitting it.
So
we're hit. I mean, we're like, how many songs do we listen to? Five? That's like five for five.
Let them eat cake.
And then they go to I don't know what you're talking about. It's very weird. You keep saying this word
that
I've never heard
Google.
Before.
Now I feel so gaslit.
And in 2009, the band would release the album Rum and Coke. It's like it was Robin when he was 18, drinking his one drink he drank, Rum and Coke.
We know somebody else who drinks that drink. Ciders.
Pirates?
And
yeah, pirates.
We know them.
We know someone who likes to drink Rum and Coke. Pirates.
We know. We have a friend who might like this drink.
Our friend Edward. He might catch him on the high seas drinking rum and Coke.
He's the modern pirate.
And this is a song called I'm in Love.
We got some W.
Like
some W dubs.
Dub
this is my dub dance. Oh, loves a ragamuffin.
She loves the ragamuffin.
Yep.
Whoa.
Am I not allowed to say that? Bacon. I just, that was trying to be British. That was not Jamaican. That was just me trying to have a British accent. What you heard is on you. There was no attempt at a Jamaican accent. What came out is what came out, but there was no Jamaican intention.
This is a good song.
Yeah, this is good.
I did Google if it was Cake who sang short skirt, long jacket, and it is true. I did.
I just feel like it can't possibly be true what you're saying right now. Like, this doesn't. The evidence suggests otherwise. Now, I'm not gonna lie. The next track on the Rum and Coke album, "Keep the Fire Burning." It might be the best yet. I
really
could not believe it when I heard this. And this is no joke. Whether or not there were jokes earlier, which I disagree that there were. This is a really good song. But I think it's obvious. You can listen to this and you can feel like this is a Rob song.
It's kind of spooky, too.
Oh, yeah.
It's all kind of spooky. That's fun. In the rain and the heartache, this is a good it's hard to see spooky month. Life. Was that Send Jamaican? As the dam breaks, do you dance on the
edge of a knife? It's time to make your is this person felt. Singing this one of the same people who does the rapping?
No, it's like a new wave guy.
I was going to say, this sounds so familiar. Do you know who it is?
I couldn't recognize who he was. Yeah.
What's the song called?
Keep the Fire Burning.
Yeah, this song rocks.
Yeah, this is very good.
It's like if you got like a gothy new wave guy to sing in a ska song.
Yeah.
It's so good. Damn, that's good. I listened to it a few times. Just
Justin Robertson?
Yes, that's who it was. Who I don't recognize any of the bands he was in.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it could just
he
be.
He sounds just so familiar.
It's very of the style, I think.
I guess.
You know, of your Depeche Modes and your et ceteras.
I wonder if he like wrote Depeche Mode songs, and that's kind of what I'm hearing. You know what I mean?
He's got a very familiar vocal.
Yeah, yeah, cadence and stuff. Anyways, it's just super familiar.
How do you feel? Dub
this
is
good.
So far,
so good. This has been
loving it.
That whole playlist that I got from Craigie Boys.
Yeah, Craig's killing it.
Amazing. Yeah. So
very good.
With that, why don't we take a break and come back and we'll listen to the last few. Welcome back to Checkered Past. We're here talking about the Dub Pistols, England's big beat ska reggae dub out. Wait, what's the word I'm looking for? Outfit. Band? Outfit. Yeah, sure. That's good.
Band.
And ensemble?
CD.
CD. And now we're on to 2012's Worshipping the Dollar, and let's listen to a couple tracks off there. This first one's called Rocksteady.
Where are they shipping that dollar to?
Now it's getting a little bit more electronic. More effects.
Yeah, this is already more like a... yeah,
oh my god, it is.
Like it good Lord. Now.
Is that bacon Jamaican?
Snow.
Snow.
There's white Jamaicans.
Yeah, but he's from Toronto. So I'm pretty sure he's a white Jamaican guy. I think he's a white guy of Jamaican descent, but I think he grew up in Toronto, so I don't know.
Correct.
This is great, though. And I was going to say, this now is kind of turning
lasers.
Into... Yeah. The sound is more kind of modern dub, like electronic dub now, I would say.
This is just snow. I keep waiting for Informer. Do you think Craig knows about Informer by Snow?
Maybe he likes the Daddy
I think
Yankee
he'd like it.
Cover, remember?
Oh, yeah. I forgot about
that. Oh, of Informer? Yeah.
I think it was Daddy
Yankee. It's like an interpolation
that sounds
of it.
Sweet.
It's not. Oh.
No, I think Snow is on the song.
Is he?
I think so. Let me look it up.
This is good, though. I like this.
This is. What year was that?
Snow featuring Daddy Yankee.
Damn.
Whoa.
Daddy Yankee and Snow featuring Con Daddy Palma Yankee. Is the. Yeah, and it's. Yeah, it's Informer.
What year was that song we just listened
2012.
To? 2012. That's interesting. It sounds so early aughts to me.
Could be.
Yeah, yeah, it does kind of have like a.
It not no, but it does seem like that seems late for what the sound is.
Also, you know what else that sounded like? 311.
Mm-hmm.
That was a very 311 style.
That's
song.
Not my favorite. That's not. That's probably my least favorite of what we've heard.
Oh, it took a bit, but we finally.
I
found
don't
a,
hate it.
We finally yeah. found a.
I won't listen
a bummer.
To it twice. Not a bummer. Yeah. Just like kind of like a meh.
Yeah, I liked it, but.
Still keep the fire burning.
Yeah, the other ones had kind of more of like a skate, big beady sound, and this one is more like a modern electronic dub sort of sound, which
yeah.
is. It's fine. It's just different.
And so the next song off the album, let's see if it's an album, not problem, but an album feature. This one's called West End Story, Worshipping the Dollar. I should look up some facts about dub pistols. Let's find some facts about them.
Only fun ones.
Fun facts. Fund facts.
Check out my only funds. Only funds.
That's what I call my bank account.
Only funds.
On that bass.
Yeah, this is good. This is kind of more a throwback to their older sound, for sure.
This sounds more modern. The production seems good. The vocals sound really good.
Yeah.
It sounds like it was done in a fancy studio with fancy mics. He's enunciating a lot. As if it's not their meat stuff, making the weapons that are doing
all the killing, and we ain't saying a thing. We're too busy blinging, but who pays the check? Yes,
too
sick.
Busy
yeah.
blinging.
This is good.
This is a very good flow.
Yeah.
He does kind of have the same accent as like an Ali G.
Respect.
Right?
I like that one. That yeah.
Ali G vibes.
Here's okay. Here's the only fun facts I've found so far. Okay. They've been on soundtracks Blade 2, Bad
Sick.
Company, Piranha 3D, and Mystery Men.
Woo, Mystery Whoa, Men. What
yeah.
song? Man,
yeah.
didn't get that far.
Our
pistols. Mystery Man.
That's fun.
Go back and listen to our Smash Mouth episode for more
keep
talk
it moving.
Of Mystery Men.
Keep moving?
Keep moving is the name of the song.
I wonder what the context was.
They have done remixes for Ian Brown's Dolphins Were Monkeys.
Oh, my favorite.
Limp Bizkit's My Way.
That makes sense.
Sweet.
Crystal Method's Do It. And Moby's James Bond theme.
Is Moby Big
I
Beat?
I forgot he did that.
He has some big beat
he has
songs.
Some,
he's mostly like,
in the
yeah,
big beat waters.
He does a lot of like more like
trance.
Yeah, relax.
Chill out.
Trance music is a very specific
I
thing
know.
That starts quiet and gets loud at the end.
Yeah, but, I don't yeah. like it.
It's,
except actually, that's
I don't have
not true. There's some trance.
I don't have patience
like.
For trance. I don't have the time.
Cascada does some trance, I think.
That's floor on the floor. Like, what do you call that? Where it's just like a beat like crazy, almost like.
Okay, I'm thinking of one. Yeah. There's an Always On Your Mind remix, I think, of a Cascada song.
Oh, yeah.
And I don't know who's by.
Is it Cascada or Cascada?
I don't know.
Okay.
I just went for it.
Video game soundtracks that they were in were Frequency.
Hey, that was a fun game.
Matt Hoffman and Tony Hawk.
Mm-hmm.
Final Fight, one of the sequels.
Yeah.
NBA Live, Tiger Woods PGA Tour.
Sick.
FIFA. Oh, that makes sense.
Yeah, that does
They're
make
just
sense.
Like big on video
Dance,
game
Dance
music?
Revolution X. Yes.
They're
what
probably,
was, what
they're probably
does
big
it say on DDR?
Yeah, the song Open.
Probably,
that sounds familiar.
They're probably big on making money off of licensing.
I mean,
oh,
hell yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Hell
yeah. Yeah, totally.
Get paid.
Like,
get
nothing
paid,
wrong
no.
with that. But that's
like a
why.
Fun way of selling out to video games.
Yeah.
That's fun. What a
yeah.
fun way to introduce people to your music.
I would just be like, it'd be just fun for me if like I had a song that was just like if you were playing like an Uncharted and you're like sneaking up on dudes and they're like hanging out in their like little camp, and then your song is like playing on the radio.
Yeah, you're like sneaking up on dudes,
and they're like playing like I'm running in a cyclone, right?
Yeah,
that'd be fun.
Yeah,
you'd like to see it.
Yeah, a cyclone.
Totally. Well, and in the 2000s, like the mid 2000s, that was like a legitimate way for a band to like gain traction. Like Avenged Sevenfold owes like half of their fame and success to the fact that they were like on Madden games and stuff.
Goldfinger.
Yeah, Goldfinger too,
said
for
it,
sure.
They said if it wasn't for Tony Hawk, they wouldn't have had a career.
Yeah, right?
Yeah.
That's crazy.
So,
yeah.
And now he's on Air Buddy's music, Goldfinger guy.
I thought you said, and now he's on Air Bud, and I was like, huh?
Hopefully.
I hope he's
I wonder if he's going to produce that new Blink 182, since he produced their last few.
The new song sure sounds like he did.
Oh, shots fired.
Just it has his signature sound. That's all
bad.
I'm saying.
He's got that.
Not for me, personally.
Podcast for enemy. Like podcast for enemy. John Feldman.
John Feldman. That's his name. Feldy.
No, he doesn't give a fuck
Do
about
you
it.
Call him Feldy?
Feldy's his nickname, yeah.
Other people call him Feldy?
Yeah, he's Feldy, yeah.
Not to be confused with Fieldy, the bass player for Korn.
No, to be confused.
Why? Important.
Get them mixed up.
Because it's fun what? To mix them up.
That's you shouldn't. You should mix them up.
That is funny. I would love to see... like
someone
John Feldman with his fucking suit that he wears nowadays. He's always got a suit with a skinny tie, and he shows up at Korn and he's playing bass.
That's fun.
Very funny. He's got his like bleach blonde hair.
Yeah,
great band.
I like it. That's so cool. Actually, I'd pay a couple $100 to see Korn if I got to see that.
A couple $100.
I'm not paying a couple $100 to see anything.
My disposable income is not spent correctly often.
You're remember, like a band that I don't like with one guy who's a frenemy of my podcast.
Yeah,
several right. hundred dollars.
Donate to my OnlyFunds.
Dan.
All right, let's keep
You're going. Donating to Feldy's OnlyFunds.
The next album. Next album that we're going to talk about is called 2015's Return of the Pistoleros. And the song is called This Anthem. I've been doing two songs per album.
In This Anthem?
Yeah, in This Anthem.
It's taken its love from me. This Anthem.
Oh, I get it. This is rad. That was fun. I don't know what he said, but that was fun. Pistolero never conform with the norm because we're dangerous. That's rad. It's good. This is weird though. Kind of weird.
Yeah, I keep trying to like find the groove.
Find the downbeat.
Yeah, I'm trying to find the groove.
The upbeat's there.
But the yeah. Oh,
there it is.
There it is. I like this better. With it all kicking in.
But it's got a little hook.
Yeah, it had no like it had, we like weird. Bass going on now. It's got like weird.
This is ska.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. The bass does have a little bit of a Bootsy Collins.
The chorus does it for me more than the verses.
Yeah.
But it's
a fun song.
Yeah. Not bad.
The next one on the same
album. I usually
album
hear worse on this part.
Turn Up.
I like to do that.
It's very similar to the last one and vibe, I feel. They've definitely gone more dubby, reggae in the 2010s.
Yeah.
The dub 1010?
Dub 1010.
In the year dub 1000. This one's kind of boring.
More grooves.
Yeah.
Than like.
Okay, well, this is kind of fun. This is sweet.
I thought you would dig.
Yeah, okay. Well, not, yeah, I am. I'm in now.
Now
I'm
getting
in.
Into like the almost dance hall-y.
Yeah, this is very dance hall-y.
This group is for
everybody.
Sparking up a doobie and pushing your skateboard around town. This is like totally headphones, backpack.
Oh, yeah. This is
riding around
music
on your skateboard.
Yeah.
Okay, what's this band called again?
The Dub Pistols.
I keep wanting to call them the Dub City All Stars. Is that a band? No, that's like Hub City Stompers, but then also someone's an all-star.
There's a Long Beach Dub All-Star.
Yeah, you. Long Beach Dub All-Stars.
That one song told you you were an all-star.
And what did I say? Dub City All-Stars?
And then there's
that's what I keep wanting to call them.
What is it?
What's the one from Winnipeg?
Dub City
All-Stars? Dub City something. Or no, Sub City Dwellers.
So yeah. And then there's also I'm trying to think of the band that does like the cover albums, All-Stars.
Easy Star All-Stars.
Easy Star All-Stars.
Yeah.
And this is the Dub City Pistols.
Yeah.
No, just Dub Pistols.
Dub Pistols.
No cities.
I agreed with it.
There's no cities.
Dub Pistol Stompers.
So we move on. To 2017. We're coming to the modern era.
We're coming to the modern era.
This is the title track on Crazy Diamonds. It's called Crazy Diamonds.
Well, these diamonds are crazy.
I can't keep them.
We're coming to the modern area. We're getting crazy with these diamonds.
Shine on.
Crazy diamonds.
Something. Shine bright like you're beautiful, like in the sky.
This bass is rad. It's very bassy.
This is pretty fun.
Yeah, it's good.
I like the vocals, the vocal groove.
I like the piano.
That's a nice touch.
Yeah, it kind of makes it soulful.
This is like smart music. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It all like works, but it's pretty unique, and there's a lot going on.
Yeah, it's totally. There's a lot happening.
But it works. They clearly have like a very horn, trumpet. Is it
trumpet?
I don't know. I think I asked you already what that's from. The trumpet. What is it,
Joey?
Mambo number 5.
Yeah. That's what they say in Mambo.
The trumpet.
When
the trumpet?
When?
Like before it goes.
I was like, when he's like listing names, he's like Monica, Louisa, the trumpet.
I wish. I hope somebody makes an edit of it like that.
This
the
is like
trumpet's getting sweeter.
A little trumpet by my side. It's good.
Just do that on a loop too. Yeah.
Just like, every line is like just a little hour. Trumpet on my side.
Like you know how they have those songs, like they just make like a song an hour long.
Yeah,
like,
it's
like a 10-second sound bite. Yeah.
Yeah, you gotta
that's
do that.
Like fucking nightmare fodder.
A little bit of trumpet
by my side. A little bit of trumpet by my side. A little bit of trumpet by my side.
I can just take your vocals and do that. I like that.
It's me doing it.
Oh, this is funny. All right. Never Never is the next song on Crazy Diamonds.
Here we go.
Also, why was Joey the Mambo number 5 expert?
Because I knew. Me and Lou go way back.
There's sweet D&B on this song.
Oh yeah, I can tell it's coming.
Yeah.
That roll, that building roll.
I thought you said D&D.
Oh,
not
they,
D&B.
They chill.
Oh,
they tricked you.
And then they bust into it later.
They bust into it.
They do a nice little jungle rhythm and it's sick. I do like drum and bass.
That fucking hi-hat's going though. It's letting the cat out of the bag.
It's like we're ready. Once the snare goes nuts, you know we're in.
I like space sounds. I like when there's a dub break or like a reggae break, and then there's just space sounds going on. It's great. Oh, here it comes.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, okay. This is, I don't mind, I guess, this. When it's done appropriately.
Yeah, like the breakbeat, like D&B stuff's great.
It can be. It could also be a bunch of like white dudes doing weird things with their hands in a corner. Like,
that's like where you were listening to that music, though.
No, they're always doing this. Patrons, you get this. They're always doing this. They're always dancing with their hands fast, and they're doing weird things in a corner to themselves because they're high on drugs. And they're like, this is for me. And I'm like, I guess it is. But
it's like
pretty aggressive music,
yeah.
And they're just dancing like that?
Yeah.
That's not the first time you've done that.
Never. I've never done that before.
Let's get to the last one, the last couple songs we got here. 2020's Addict. We're going to start with Go Tell Your Friends.
This is already fun. I'm in. I'm sold.
This guy's definitely going to call me a bumbaclod.
Well, don't be one then.
Yeah, that's my problem. Yeah. I keep walking around like a bumbaclod and I'm getting called out.
Look over my there.
My favorite part about bumbaclod is that it is just like a bum cloth. You're just a cloth that someone used to wipe their bum, Rob.
Yeah. That's I know. It. I just keep doing There's no... They're not wrong. That's the problem. I recognize what they see.
Yeah, this is very good. Fun.
I like this a lot. Yeah.
Yeah, this is sick.
Has a similar vibe to like
Shaggy's vocals.
Yeah, actually,
that's all I've been thinking. I was like, Mr. Lover, Lover.
Not what I was gonna say. But yeah.
I was like, yes, I've been thinking it too. But then you reacted differently, so I was like, that's not what you were gonna say. I was like, that's dumb. Don't
say
that.
I was gonna say like, Heaven is a half pipe. It has kind of like a similar vibe. But now
it's
Shaggy.
Yeah, Heaven
is a half pipe.
Heaven would be telephone-tastic.
Is that what he says?
Yeah.
That's fun.
Let's finish it off with the song Stand Together from 2020's right Addict. Over me. Oh, Rhoda's on this song. She sings.
Oh, that's fun.
Yeah. Oh, by the way, I meant Shaggy Too Dope.
Oh, yeah, obviously.
Oh, I was talking about Shaggy from Scooby-Doo.
Yeah, right.
Norville.
They're all Mr. Boombastic.
I was almost gonna do it. And I don't know if I can do it.
A Shaggy impression?
But like singing Shaggy.
Yeah, like, I don't it's have gotta be out there.
Like you got me running in a cycle, old man.
Yeah. It's the Boombastic.
Scoob.
Her vocals do sound very good.
She's so good.
She's got some like insane tone, hey.
Oh yeah.
It's so like earthy Pipes. And deep. Yeah.
As much as I love her solo stuff, and I really think there was a moment where we could have had Body Snatchers music and it would have been great. But because that third specials album is kind of shit, and it sucks that she was the singer on it.
Yeah. But she can sing.
She can sing. There's
no
question.
She can fucking sing.
Dub Pistols, how do we feel? We all listen to Dub
Pistols.
I'd
say I like them.
They're very, very good.
It's very good.
And their not ska stuff that's on their albums is also very good.
That one song was a little weird.
The one on
that one song.
The one that you're like, I like it, but it's a little weird.
The cake song?
Yeah, that's
no, that was really good. I don't know what you're talking about.
It was
about.
Just a little weird.
It's just strange. That
it
you
was
keep
strange
saying,
to me.
Yeah,
I don't know why strange. You keep saying it's cake, though. And I don't know who that is.
The cake is a lie, is what you're saying.
Oh, reference for video game players out there. The gamers.
Cake is a lie. And what cake is it? Black Forest.
Was it? No, it was like a birthday cake.
Black Forest cake. Mm. This was trivia on How Did This Get Played?
Well... Thanks for listening to Check
Your
Pass.
Oh, that's
it? That's it, yeah.
Hey, bye.
Hey.
I liked this band.
They're very good.
Yeah.
I guess you said that.
Yes.
So no one, no resolution on cake? No.
I don't know what you're talking about. It's
no.
All the way to the last 5 minutes, you're still harping on this cake thing?
Oh, is it in the outro? Maybe it's in the outro. Maybe it's in the outro.
What do we call that guy? A little man? Earlier,
what do we call that guy? Terry Hall of the Specials.
Yeah, he was a little man. Little man. Well,
little man.
Thank you to the little man that sent us this playlist.
Oh,
hit us up on Instagram, Twitter, and TikTok at CheckeredPassPod, or send us an email at CheckeredPassPod@gmail.com. Ask a question for the show, suggest bands, and bring us games to play. We have merch available at CheckeredPass.ca, including shirts, mugs, and toques for the cold weather.
Beanies.
Please like, subscribe, tell your friends, and rate us 5 stars on Apple Podcasts. This episode is produced and engineered by Joey, and the playlist is available on Common Sense Kids Spotify, so we'll share it on our socials. The TromBonus theme is provided by Keelan, and next week we will have Eichlers on the podcast to talk Sublime.
For that, for sure.
Yeah. And until next time, I'm Rob.
Cake.
Joey.
In the immortal words of Dub Pistols, I want a girl with a short skirt and a long jacket.